Hey guys, I'm here with another tutorial. I got a very sweet comment from Elena, if you look down on my previous video from a day ago. She was really sweet, and I checked out her makeup channel, and she does these beautiful, gorgeous, dramatic looks. I was kind of fooling around after watching her videos, and I found this really I came up with this really pretty dramatic look. Not as dramatic as hers, because I'm not that talented yet, but I will get there. Anyway, I'm going to have a little bit of music playing in the background, because I noticed that when I'm concentrating, I'm not talking, and so you guys are just like staring at me doing something. And so I'm going to have a little bit of background music. I haven't figured out how to really, you know, make a good YouTube video with, like, you know, text and background music where you could hear it clearly and not just like on my phone. So I had coffee and I get really giggly with coffee. I don't drink a lot of caffeine, and so now I'm like, oh, hi. Okay. And then I'm gonna do sort of like a quick tutorial on brows. I just did them myself like maybe 3 or 4 days ago. I might have to touch them up again because I don't think I got them evenly, but you know, can't really afford to go get them done, so I'm doing my best. But to fill them in, I'm gonna do like a brief tutorial on what I do and what I think works best. For me, at least. So like always, I'm going to start with a moisturizer. Well, first I'm going to do the Uplifting Beauty Serum. And it says to apply 3 to 4 drops on your fingers. Damn it. You know what? I'm not gonna do this one because then I have to cut the tip, and I don't want to have to keep getting up in the middle of the videos because I'm so loony and can't remember everything. Oh, come on! Okay, looks like I'm gonna be getting up anyway. Sorry, I'll get better at that. So I'm just gonna cut off the tip. Okay. So it says apply gently to areas of concern, frown lines, crow's feet, fine lines along the forehead, or brows, between the brows. Well, I don't really have crow's feet or frown lines. At least I don't think. Not really, no, because I'm still 23. I just turned 23, so I really don't need that. But I'm going to do this one. So 3 to 4 drops on tips of fingers and apply gently to face and neck. It's my first time using these, because... Oh! That came out quickly. It says apply to face and neck. Okay. And that's like really soft. I really like that. It doesn't have that, like, how most serums, like, have that sticky residue. Same with the lip glosses. Like, you know how you're gonna go buy lip glosses from, like, Walmart or something, and they always have that sticky residue. I don't like that feeling, and our lip glosses don't have that. they're beautiful shades, and they don't have that sticky residue. And same with our serums and stuff. Like, in Elena's comment, she said that my skin was really beautiful without makeup. And I really love that she said that. It's this royalty collection. I swear to God, it works. So I'm using that much. And this is the Divine Daily Moisturizer. So, and a little goes a long way. So if you buy like the full bottles of everything, I'm not joking. Like, everything lasts a long time. You don't need a lot. And I really love that about this company. You get great product, and it lasts a long time because you don't have to use a lot to get the results that you like. I was going to do the liquid, but I decided that I'm going to use my cream, and then I'm going to, and this is into feta. And then I'm going to use the Organza liquid foundation for concealer, because I haven't bought concealer. I mean, I have some left from department store before I started this company, but I'm trying to make this channel all about Unique. So I don't want to improvise with products from other companies, because then it's not really a Unique channel, you know? See, I've had this a while, and there's still a lot of product in there. It's just amazing. So with the lighting, I can't tell if you can really tell, but it matches my skin perfectly. This is Tefeta. It's for, I'm trying to remember what the shades are. Okay, it's Tefeta's medium to light with neutral undertones. That's what it was. So I'm gonna do the bronzers and the blushes next. And do some contouring. So I'm gonna use Hermosa right there. And this is our Beachfront Bronzer Collection. I'm going to mix it with Malibu, which was the middle one. I'm gonna use this brush that seems to attract more. Just clean it off a little bit because I mainly use it for blushes. Thank you. And I use the excess on the side of my nose, like always. Then for blush, I'm going to use this contouring brush. And I'm going to use Seductive, which is like this deep mauve color. And since I have an oval face, I'm going to start at the apple of my cheeks and sweep upward. Okay, so now that that's on, I'm going to start with a cream shadow today, and then I'm going to make it more matte with my Moodstruck Addiction number 4 palette. But I'm going to do the cream last. That way I can make the matte look first and then just apply the cream over. So, I'm going to apply Brave, which is this pretty brown color, number 3 in, I should say, and apply it to my crease. I'm just gonna tap it in. And then sweep it in to meet the bottom, the top of my upper lash line. And then just sweep it out to blend it in. Forgot to turn off that alarm. I'm going to do the same on the other side, so hopefully, well, yeah, you can see. And then sweep it in to meet the top of your upper lash line. And then keep tapping along the crease. And then with the excess, if one side's always darker, like it seems to be for me, I just tap it again on the other one and just keep doing it until it looks even. But I'm gonna blend it in anyway, so. So I'm gonna take this brush and then just start blending. And then I like to take my contouring brush and just sweep across the eyelids in quick motions. That way it looks a bit lighter. And then I'm going to take take it again and then tap again and make it a little darker. The trick for dramatic looks, in my opinion, and this works for me, is to keep making it lighter and then going back with excess . That way you can make sure that it's completely even. And I'm just sweeping to the top of my upper lash line. Put a little more product on here. And now I'm just doing sweeping motions. And then I'm gonna go back and blend it. It may look like extreme now, but just wait till I start blending in everything. So now I'm gonna use this one right here, the thin one, and I'm gonna take Secretive, the fourth one in, that pretty gold color. And I'm gonna take some of that and put it in my crease. So when I go back to blend it, it looks a little bit lighter, but it still looks like a smoky. I'm sort of just tapping it in, and then I'm going to go to Arrogant, which is the second one in, and it's sort of like a dark camel color, sort of, it's just like a taupe, and then I'm going to tap it over Secretive and more upward. I'm gonna take my blendy brush and just blend that in. Then I'm just gonna take my contour brush and just lightly sweep it. I'm going to take my blendy brush again and put a little bit of Secretive back on there. And go towards the bottom of my crease, close to my lid, and just blend it in that way. So when I put the gold cream eyeshadow on, it looks like it blends together. Or it's blended together, I should say. I'm gonna take my contour, sweep. And then I'm gonna take the spongy end right here and go to Tender, which is the first one, the lightest shade in this palette. And just tap it from the tear duct to the middle of the lid. And sweep down at the inner tear duct and just tap it in to the middle of the lid. And then, like I always do, sweep it from the front up onto my brow bone. And then do the same on the other side. Sweep it down in the tear duct. And then sweep from the front up onto the brow bone. So you can see it. Wish we had better lighting. Yeah, that's not working. I gotta start doing these more during the daytime. I wasn't really planning on doing one today, but... And so now that I have my palette 4 open, I'm going to go to the brows and do a quick brief tutorial on that. I left my comb thing up there, but that's okay. So I'm going to be as close up as possible. So I'm going to use Brave, third one in, and make it like a gel liner brush or a brow brush. And just tap in the product, and then I start from the end. Well, sort of the beginning of the arc, sweep to the end first. And then, after I did that, I brushed from the front. I sort of slant it so it's not completely dark. And then turn it more normally once I get close to the arc. And then now that most of the product is off, I keep it upright. And just blend evenly. And do the same on the other side. So start from the arc down to the end. keep it slanted and sort of fill it in. And then keep it upright. And just blend. And then I'm going to take this flat brush right here. Go back into my palette and put Tender, the lightest shade, and reapply at the bottom the light color to highlight and clean up any fallout. But with these palettes, there's really none. It's more for if you let your hand go away from the brow and went more onto your skin. I'm gonna apply more of the Tender at the tear duct and sweep it upward. Tear duct. Sweep up. Take it. Sweet. Just need to blend it a little bit. I'm gonna turn on my flashlight real quick so you could probably get a better look. There, now it's a little blended. Ah! No! This flashlight always has a fucking pop-up. It bugs me. See the eyebrows? Yep. So now it's time for the cream eyeshadow, and this is called Extravagant. It's a pretty gold color. And then I'm just gonna tap it on the lighter part of the lid and move a little upward. So when I go to blend it, it blends together. And do the same on the other side. So I'm just going up towards my crease.
why you always such a drone? Used to always stay at home, be a good girl, you was in the zone. So I'm gonna take the angled brush again and just go back to the crease on both sides. And it's best with a tip. See how it's angled? Right there. It's best if you angle it down. So it's pointing towards your lid. And then blend that way. That way you're not applying too much pressure. So now I'm gonna take this, my contour brush, and sweep. And then I'm gonna take a cream eyeshadow again and then tap it onto my eye more towards the front than to the middle. Tapping it and then sweeping downward. And then with the excess, I'm sweeping under. The lower lash line right there. And then I'm going to take this tip one right here and dipping it into Brave and then starting from that outer corner underneath the lash line. And sweeping outward for the point. I'll show you that in a second. and just sort of blend it in to your shadow. And then when I put on the lighter foundation for my concealer, you'll see it more cleaned up. Then make it pointed. But first I'm going to take my blendy brush. And just clean it up a little bit. And I'm going to take this side, take this fluffy brush, put it in Secretive, the gold color that I used before, not the cream one. And just tap it on the outside and towards the middle in the crease. Tap, don't sweep. That and lightly tap, don't sweep, because the excess will get onto the brush, and then you can just use it sort of like a highlighter, because it's shimmer, it takes the shimmer off, well not off, but soaks up any excess shimmer. So now I'm getting to the concealer. I'm just applying concealer the way you normally would. A little of the nose, above the lips, chin. Thank you. Then a little my brow bone. Just fixing my brows a little bit. Since I'm not using a gel, my eyebrows have a mind of their own. Sorry, there's still lotion on my hands and I couldn't get it open. So now on a mascara. I press down lightly with these because if you press too hard, it can cut your eyelashes. So beware of that. So this is our 3D Lash Mascara. And it's a lifesaver for when you want the definition of false lashes, but you don't want the hassle of the glue and making sure that it stays on all day or for the event that you might be going to. And then the fiber lashes. Remember, don't let the transplanting gel dry. And I start from the middle of my lashes and roll upward towards the tips. And then back to the transplanting gel. Then I'm doing the fiber lashes one more time. You can apply it as many times as you want to, but I like to stick with two. I want the definition, but I don't want to look like I'm walking the runway, you know? But that's just my style. Now, after you apply the fiber lashes, you do not want to curl with a curler. You want to take a blow dryer, keep it on low, but make sure it's hot, and blow upward. It'll curl your lashes.
So if you want to curl your lashes with a curler, you have to do it before you apply. And remember, do it lightly because it will cut your lashes in half. So I'm applying the transplanting gel again. Then go to the fibers. Then the transplanting gel again. Hi, honey. I'm going to the fibers again. And then the transplanting gel to lock it in. Try something. I'm gonna take the fibers because I'm gonna try something and see if you can get sort of that wing tip. You just apply more fibers to the end and maybe towards the middle. Transplanting gel. Wow, it did sort of work. Sweet. Thank you.
I like to use this brush sometimes to sort of unclump the front lashes. Well, it's not unclump, but sometimes when you apply the fibers, it'll mix together. So I like to separate it that way. And so now, I'm gonna take Brave Again. And then just sort of tap lightly. Just make it a little bit darker. To really define the wing. Now, unfortunately, I do not have. Well, that's bright. Fortunately, I do not have. A blow dryer. So, what I like to do is I like to push up and put pressure. I don't recommend this if you feel weird about touching your eyeball, because you might just a little. So, you want to get as close to the upper waterline as possible and just like sort of bend them up. Okay, so for lips, I'm gonna mix a lip stain and a lip gloss. What I really like lately is I like Sultry for the lip stain, and I love to pair it with Lucky. So this is Lucky. Unless it's Sultry lip stain. I like to rub it on my finger.
So I'm gonna take, and I got some on my fingers. So I'm gonna take my shine wipes. These leave your skin feeling very soft too, because it has olive, jojoba, sunflower, vitamin E, and rosemary oils in it. So it's very nourishing. All our products are very nourishing. Like all our moisturizers and serums and stuff, it's very moisturizing. Okay. So I'm gonna take my palette again and take Tender. And I'm gonna take Tender, the lightest shade, remember? And I'm gonna highlight my Cupid's bow. There was hair on my brush. Like to highlight there too. And then I'm gonna take a Lucky. And then just sort of tap it. And just sort of smooth it in. That way you don't take the red off. Well, it's not gonna come off, but. And then I'm going to take a little bit of Livid, which is a gold color. And just tap it on top and rub it in. Hope you saw that okay. It has a little bit of an amber tint. It's more of like an amber color now. Like, okay, so I like to call it my fire pit, because you have the dark red lip stain, you have the grayish color. So your lip stain, where was it? So your sultry is the red lick, like the way the coals look when they're burning. The gray is a stand for the embers. And the gold to stand for the color. Like the gold color of the flame. I call it my fire pit. I'm weird like that. I'll make up like a whole bunch of names. Well, that's it. I will give you one last look, best I can. And I hope you enjoy. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you. My website will be in the description below, and same with the list of products. And don't forget to subscribe. Bye.